Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to some more Madden 15 in the way of my Rob Blanchflower connected careers or connected franchise series with the Pittsburgh Steelers. Now, Blanchflower is a rookie tight end trying to make the Steelers squad out of training camp in real life, out of the University of UMass, where he was a big star in my UMass dynasty. So obviously we had to follow his football career into the NFL and his chance to make the Steelers. So we're doing the same thing. He's made the team in this version of things, but he is the third tight end on the roster, so he doesn't get a whole lot of playing time. We talked about what we wanted to do with this series. You guys said, don't make him an auto starter, make him earn it, but don't show anything other than like the actual plays he gets on the field here. So he didn't get on the field for other than special teams there, and they lose to Carolina. And that's tough because it's now 0-3 to start the season after a 33-16 loss. As far as Blanchflower personally, he can't feel too bad about it. He really hasn't had a hand in these losses at all. He's more or less watched and been out there on special teams. But he gets a chance right here. Ball is not thrown his way. He is out there in that set, however. Another play from scrimmage on 2nd and 5. Roethlisberger is going to throw to him. And there it is. His first NFL catch. At least officially, he had one for a touchdown in the preseason, but that one goes in the record book as his first catch as an NFL tight end. Great job, Rob Blanchflower, getting out there and making that catch. So it's not going to translate to a win, however. The Steelers go 0-4. Maybe they should have played Blanchflower a little bit more. I don't know. Guess we can't get too carried away. It was just one catch, but you know, give him more chances, and maybe he gives you a chance to move the football down the field. But they do have Heath Miller, and they do have, who the heck is backing him up? Oh yeah, Matt Spaeth as well. Hard to even be mad about Matt Spaeth being ahead of us in the depth chart, the good old Minnesota Golden Gopher. Yeah, there you go. Got to stick up for the Minnesota boys. So here we are developing Blanchflower through the items that'll give him XP. Now, somebody thought you could still get XP when you run the in-game drills, and it might be interesting to show that, but every time I've looked at it, it's just one chance to do in-game drills, and it's only for confidence. I have not found one yet that lets you do in-game drills that will bring your XP up, only confidence. So we're staying away from that for right now, because confidence really doesn't matter a whole lot if you're a confident player standing on the bench. You want to be out there and have the attributes to be in the lineup. So we actually take a lead in overtime there. Are we going to get the win, our first win of the year? No, it ends up in a tie against Jacksonville. Come on, you got to be kidding me. Two really poor teams, and neither one of them gets a win. I guess that's fitting. We were really hoping for our first win of the season, and when we kicked that field goal in overtime, it looked like maybe we were on our way. Nope, we tie at 20 apiece. So we're still looking for that elusive victory. Man, the Steelers 0-4-1, and it's not going to get easier. We play the 3-1 Browns. Oh boy, they're going to beat us down again. We're going to have to see here. But first, we went through and got Blanchflower his XP. We're going to go spend it now, put it into awareness and consistency. You guys were talking about those being so low that they could bring the overall up. And you're right, it bounces him to a 70 overall now. It took a while. Obviously, we'd like to have that attribute where we gained the XP earlier, but it's 15,000 XP just to get that. So it would take up a lot of the year just getting that and then not even getting any XP boost or overall boost in the meantime. So I don't know. I'm struggling with that. Just putting it into the consistency and the awareness. And right there he goes out for a pass, but you can't complete a pass when your quarterback is laying on the field after a sack. Mingo gets him. And Cleveland is all over us here, 44-16. Johnny Football, was he starting? Come to think of it, I think he started in the opener against us too. So yeah, he just laid the smackdown on the Steelers right there. We go to 0-5-1 now, is it? Man, this is a terrible washed out season already. But look at this, the Texans. We found somebody worse. They're 0-6. Somebody's got to win, right? Well, no, we showed that's not true. We already had a tie. It could happen again. But hopefully, playing at home against an 0-6 team, maybe we can break out these Bumblebee alternate throwbacks and get ourselves a win. Now, if we do, does that mean we ride the rest of the season wearing these? We'll have to see. Oh, a chance at the goal line for Blanchflower to get a touchdown, but that is knocked away by Cushing. He made a great play to step in and get a hand on this ball, as we'll see right there. Yep, he knocks that ball away and thwarts any chance at Blanchflower's first NFL touchdown. Oh, it would have been sweet, but it doesn't happen. So he's back in here, second and 10. We're down 27-14, just seconds left. And he's covered pretty well and looking to get open. He comes back to the football. Nice instincts right there. At least he can come back and help his quarterback out, who had a lot of time to throw. So now they just want to try to get into that end zone, and they do as time expires, but they're a touchdown short. They get the points there, but they're still going to lose. What is the final score? Give it to us here. 27-21. They lose by a touchdown. Shoot. All right. Well, there you go. Blanchflower gets out there for a couple more plays. Gets a handshake there at the end of the game. But it's not enough. They lose to the now 1-6 Texans. Leaves you scratching your head and wondering, when is this terrible slide going to end for the Steelers? When are they going to wake up from this nightmare? Maybe when they promote their rookie tight end? I don't know. That's a thought. I don't think they're going there, though. So still a 70 overall, and we're taking on the 4-3 Indianapolis Colts and Andrew Luck next. That doesn't sound any more fun. It is a home game. I guess we got that going for us. So go in and develop some more here week by week. Run these drills for XP. You see what they're yielding us there right there. Obviously, we'd love to get them at a quicker rate. But like I said, it's 15,000 to get that trait to speed that up. So we're not anywhere near doing that. And we're going to go ahead and go into consistency once again. And I think, are we going to bump it to 71? No, we still stay at a 70. Okay. So it's time to play the Colts. Here we go. He gets in on this play. That's going to be play action. They're not throwing to him. I think they threw to Heath Miller possibly there. No, it was to Spaeth, I think. And now another pass. This one! Oh, this is called you're so hungry to get a ball. You call for it even when you're covered. And that's a pick six. Ouch. Should not have called for the ball right there. Just a little excited to be in the ball game and actually maybe have a chance to produce a highlight. But instead, it's a highlight the other way. And that was really uncalled for at a bad time right there. Oh, all right, so we'll have to just put that one behind us and hope it doesn't cost the team. So now we're down 31-21 in the fourth, but let's kick a field goal right there. Just chip away, get a little closer. Hope to get the ball back now. We're within one score. Oh, they got a chance at another field goal, and this one is also good. So it's going to cut it 31-27 with 5 minutes to play. Once again this year in Madden 15, the simulation of when you're not on the field is kind of wonky. It goes ahead and really destroys any time of possession that you would think a team would have. So we got the ball back again, like virtually right away. Oh, and we're able to get a touchdown right there. It's 33-31. Tack on the extra point. And we got the three-point lead. Chuck Pagano says, say it isn't so. His team is the first to lose to the Steelers this year. They pull it out 34-31, and we got the first victory of the season. And let me tell you, I'm glad it didn't come in the Bumblebee throwbacks because I didn't want to have to wear those for every single home game. But there you go. We get it done 34-31. And still not much going on for young Rob Blanchflower. I think he has two or three catches on the season. And for something like 30 yards. So they're taking on the 2-6 Ravens next. All right, another team that you think we'd have a shot against at least playing at home. Is this three home games in a row? Well, guess what? That wasn't even close. The Ravens come in here and just beat us silly. That is a beatdown if I've ever seen one. So there's another loss. We still have just that one win on the season. Next up is a trip to New York to take on the J-E-T-S Jets, Jets, Jets. They're 1-8. Wow, a lot of bad teams we're taking on to go with our record here. So, once again, a bad team beats what apparently is an even worse team in the Pittsburgh Steelers as the Jets thump them 30-10. Obviously, Blanchflower was not getting into these games. I did not sim them. I played them. And, he's just doing special teams mainly, so we got to get him in as that second tight end if we want to see him more working on this here. We're going to get him to a 71 overall. And by the way, I think Spaeth is a 75. So that's what we're shooting for, I guess, to get above that. Oh, wait a second. We got an injury. And that's our number one starting tight end, Heath Miller, laying on the ground in pain. How serious is this? Well, he's riding the exercise bike right now. It looks like it's not too serious. But that pushes Blanchflower into the second tight end spot right now. Blocking for a first down run right there. Good job. They convert on 3rd-and-1. Hopefully we'll get word soon what the issue is with Heath Miller and how long he's going to be out, but this is a timeout here by the defense. They're out of them. This is going to be play action. And look at all the time for Roethlisberger to strike to the end zone. Touchdown. There you go. Long touchdown strike that, well, will seal the game and their second victory of the season. Let's watch the replay. Hey, did you know this is the Monday night game? How bad would the network hate it if this were the Monday night game? The 0-9 Titans versus the 1-8-1 Steelers. Yeah, I think this game would have gotten flexed since it was in the second half of the season. But there you go. Bruised ribs will return soon for Heath Miller, so he's not going to miss like weeks of time. And that's a victory for the Steelers, a very rare one, just the second of the season. And there you go. The Titans, I believe, are now 0-10. Ouch. So we're going to move on from this after the 29-14 victory. Maybe try to string two wins in a row. Who do we have up next as an opponent? Is it even possible? Let's see what we've got going on next. We got a bye week. Okay, well, we can't lose this week. That's good. So we just go through the bye week. Obviously doing some drills for Blanchflower. But then we come to the Saints. And wow, they're 4-7. I wouldn't have expected that. I later found out why, however. Drew Brees is apparently injured and for long term because he does not start in this game. However, New Orleans has a 21-17 lead in the third quarter. Got to do some work, and Blanchflower makes a catch for a first down right there. Roethlisberger puts it right on him, and he holds on. Nice catch as he is absorbing a hit at the same time. Two Saints players hit him, but he makes that catch. So I wanted to make the most of the opportunity. I did hurry up offense, so they couldn't take me off the field. And he hits Blanchflower again. Second straight time, Roethlisberger's over 200 yards now passing. Roethlisberger's been putting up pretty good numbers despite a really miserable record. He's been passing a lot for a lot of yardage and some touchdowns. So here we go. Can he make it three in a row? Oh, yes, he can. And will he get the first down? So close. They're going to say they're just inches away, second and inches. But Blanchflower, three catches. I think he's doubled his season production here just in three plays. There he's going to get a block on a first down run and continuing to stay in there. Let's go again here. He's going to fake the block and then try to get open in the flat. He makes the catch, but nowhere to run, just to gain a three right there. But it's his fourth catch. Could we make it five? This pass is going to go to Spaeth, and Spaeth fights for a first down. Did he get it? Well, he's close. Roethlisberger now going head-to-head with Ryan Griffin. Not Drew Brees, Ryan Griffin. And finally, we come off the field, but there is a touchdown. Pittsburgh punches it in and gets the lead. And looking for this extra point. That'll give us the lead 24-21 with about 2 minutes left in the third quarter. So it's now 31-21, a field goal attempt. And we're stretching out this lead in the fourth. Could we win two games in a row? It's starting to look that way. 37-21, play action. Why not go for another play here? That's a huge pancake block by Blanchflower down the field. So here we have a run. No, they're going to go play action. And it's a big first down to Blanchflower. First and goal. They fooled him on the play action yet again. What a catch for the kid there. Now he's got five catches for, I believe he goes 55 yards. We'll check the stats here. I believe that's what it was. But they get a big 44-21 win. And Blanchflower sees his most action of the season, primarily because I forced it there. Got on the field and ran with an opportunity, going no huddle. No huddle with the jumbo set, making sure we had three tight ends. How about that? But that's a big win for where we came from starting this season. So we see a couple highlights with Blanchflower now that we have a couple to show. A nice catch right there. I think that was the last one. They got the first and goal and pretty much secured things. And this was earlier on coming across the field. Just wanted to show a couple close-up action shots here of Blanchflower doing his work now that he's finally able to say he's got something on his resume there. So five catches for 55 yards. Yes, nice day right there from the tight end. He outdoes Heath Miller. And they get this victory. So that's in the books. 44-21 win over a Saints team minus Drew Brees. So what's going to be up next when we come back next time? The 5-6-1 Bengals. They've tied a game too, and it wasn't against us. How about that? Two ties in one season in the NFL. So it'll be another chance to get a victory and maybe some more playing time for Blanchflower next time out. I hope so. The kid deserves to play, right? Let's get him in there. All right. Thanks for joining me for more Rob Blanchflower Connected Careers. We'll see you next time with more Madden 15. Bye, guys.
Thanks for watching.
If you enjoyed the video, go ahead and join the SGU team. Like the SGU Facebook page. Follow us on Twitter. Go ahead and subscribe to SGU here on YouTube so you don't miss daily videos. And last but not least, follow us on Twitch for live streaming goodness.